the Lord, he placed in my heart a particular passage of scripture, which is Matthew chapter 8, verses 23 through 26. And so I'm going to read it really quickly. It says, "And after he meaning Jesus, got into the boat, his disciples followed him. And suddenly, behold, there arose a violent storm on the sea, so that the boat was being covered up by the waves, but he was sleeping. And they went and awakened him, saying, Lord, rescue and preserve us. We are perishing. And he said to them, Why are you timid and afraid, O you of little faith? Then he got up and rebuked the winds and the sea, and there was a great and wonderful calm, a perfect peacefulness. So the Lord, he dropped three main points into my heart. The first point is about storms. So all of us in this room, we deal with storms and different problems and situations that arise in our lives. For young people, many of us, we deal with situations at school where sometimes, you know, we might not have done so well on a test, we might be in jeopardy of failing a class, or we might deal with problems and situations with our friends. Maybe our friends are doing something and we know we shouldn't be doing, so we might have to turn away from them. We deal with situations at home with our parents, and also just trying to be able to find ourselves and find our identity in this world, whether it's I'm trying to figure out a career that we want to pursue, or figuring out just exactly what our talents is. And with these storms, it leads me into my second point, that when these storms do come up and arise in our lives, we shouldn't feel that we are alone, or we shouldn't feel abandoned, but we should know that God is with us through every situation that we are faced with. Because a lot of times when we do have storms and things that come in our lives, we might not tend to seek God first. We sometimes tend to lean onto our own understanding, and that sometimes makes the storms in our life actually bigger than what they actually are. Or if we do pray and read the word, sometimes we may think that God doesn't hear us because he's taking just way too long to answer our prayers. And sometimes we might be thinking that God is sleeping on our problems and our situations. And we might feel like the disciples on the boat, we might feel afraid, scared, helpless, and we may even panic. But God wants us to know, which leads into my third point, to know that we do not need to be afraid. We do not need to be timid or panic, but we need to have faith. Faith to know that he will deliver us from any problem or any situation that may arise in our lives. And the faith can be as small as a mustard seed, because in the Bible it talks about how your faith as a mustard seed, it can move mountains. Yeah. So it doesn't matter how large the storm is, just have faith and stand firm and strong in the Lord and know that he will deliver us. Yeah. So just to wrap up, I just want to encourage everyone in here today to know that God is greater than all of our problems combined. There is no storm too large in our lives that Jesus cannot calm. When storms do come in our lives, do not be dismayed and do not feel abandoned, but know that Jesus is right there listening. He's right there on the boat with us. And also to know that, to not be afraid, but to stand firm in your faith, and to know that when we are faced with difficult times and situations, just know that Jesus, he is the calm in the storm. Amen.